Thank you. Hello. Hi. Dog Plays MC's Minecraft says, "Hi, I'm Alex Plays 246. Can I join?" Look at the title, and I don't know if you can go. So yeah. Yeah, but can you hear me? Can you hear me? Not sure. Say it in the chat if you can hear me. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Please. I hope so. Okay. I need to know it. Come on, someone say something. Can you hear me? Okay, I'll. Yes. Okay. So this is a coding stream, and we are going to make a program, and I'm going to show you and explain you how to make your own programs. This is my program on making plugins. There are more programs than IntelliJ, but this is more for experienced people. So let's create a new project. We are going to make something simple, like a game, and not a Minecraft plugin, but a game. Minecraft runs on Java, that's a programming language, and I'm going to learn you Java. So let's make a project. Please do it. Oh, I need to share my screen. Wait, I don't know why this is strange, but Amazon. There you go. Okay. So we are going to select Java. We can make an Android plugin, but nah. Just Java, and then next. We are going to use this one. So we create project from template, command line app. Next. And we give it a name. I'm going to do this in a different folder. Development, programs. I know, this is a different language. How are we going to call it? Oh. Nope, that's not a song. Better. Okay. So, let's go to the next song. Tutorial. Okay, and add the folder to this. So, tutorial. Okay, now the package. The package is a sort of folder. And if your website or your domain is lawrencehub.com, switch it with com.lawrencehub, and then the project name, tutorial. Oh, with a T. And we are done with this. So we click on finish. Oh, that's a message. Nothing wrong with that. Okay. You can see the it's loading everything. Okay. Okay, so this is the IntelliJ. This can look different. Oh, hello, Guinea. I started 9 minutes. Okay. I know. Okay, but I'm still making the project. So we made a project, and it can look different for you if you start coding. This is the structure for the methods, etc. And I'm going to learn how to make your own program. Dog plays MC Minecraft says, wanna play Skywars on Bedwars after? Yes, sure. One thing what you need to make programs is Java. I'm using 1.7 now, and you need IntelliJ or Eclipse or okay, this IntelliJ. That's this on Java. That's a programming language, Java GDK. That's a program what you need to make programs. Okay. If you don't see this. Like this. If you don't see this, you can click on project. Once you see this thing, what I want this, okay. You can click here on src. That's the your folder to make your files in. So you click. And you see your package with a strange thing. That's called a class, and it's sort of a file for you. And yeah. And you see, IntelliJ typed something in here because we asked for it for a command line. So when we run the code on top here, at the right green arrow, you can see here at the bottom it's building. So we are waiting for the build. Okay. And almost done. This is the first time, so it takes longer. And can you guys hear the music? So it opened a console with nothing in it because we need to type some code here. So how do we want to make we want to run some text. So we start with system dot out dot print lm. That stands for line. And you see this dot comma. Always do this at the end of a line. And this does nothing. We can run it here. But as you can see, it's running nothing. Oh, it's still loading. Okay. But this is a class with the package, and it runs nothing. So this is the class with the package and the method. Public stands for it's everyone can look in it. So when you spigot is for Minecraft plugins, and you can do player. This is hard to explain when you guys know nothing. But we are just going to start with coding. Okay, but we want to return a message. We have now some empty air. So yeah, how are we going to do that? One line of text is called a string. a string. It's a line of text. Why did I put these slashes here? Because that's how you make a comment. Or you can do it with a slash, star, and press enter. Or you can type in here. So, two slashes is one line comment. Okay, but now we want to do run a text. That's a string. But how do we make a string? Well, you make it by typing this twice. So we have a sort of when someone says something hello. Hello, I'm in a book. You normally see this with these. So when someone says something, it's in these. I don't know the word for these things because I'm not English, but once you type a text in them. So this is the first line. Okay. Now we run the code, what it's building and making the code. Yeah. And you see, this is the first line. Okay, that works. But if we type this again, but then with something different. And say something in chat if you don't understand something, because I can help you. And we see different, but this is hard to make, because if you want to make more lines, you always need to type system.out.println. But they made something like this, backslash n, and then type second line. Okay, we typed two lines of code, but with the second one, it has a slash n in string. And string is new line in the string. Okay. So we have a second line here, three lines with that. Okay, now we are going to work with objects, because a class is an object, and Java is an object-oriented programming language. That means when I type, I need to declare a variable with an object. So I'm going to make a string called test. How do you start? You start with the object, that string, and then the name of the variable or the object is test, and then we can do the same. Hi. So when you run the code, okay. Okay. Something was happening in the chat, so I had to kick him while he was typing it in Dutch, but yeah, but I kicked him from my channel. Okay, but as you can see here, it's giving, I typed this first line and second line, but it's not typing the high. And when you hover on this and says variable test is never used. And at the right side you see the errors and warning, but here it says it too. Okay. So how do we print it? Well, we can use this and then again I. But instead of doing that, we can use the object what we made called test. So when we type test in here, now it works. So it should print a line with hi. And I got 4 viewers, nice, or watchers, how do you want to call it? Okay, and you see hi here, okay. But let's start with some numbers. How do we start now? Well, numbers is different because we have many sorts of numbers. We have integers, doubles, longs, and floats. Okay. We have 32-bit numbers and 64-bit numbers. My computer has 64-bit. Most of the computers have 64-bit computers now. And what that means is 1, 1. It can count like this with zeros and ones, and it has a maximum value for number or this. Okay, we have 2 types of numbers. Yeah, I said already 32-bit and 64-bit, but we have with decimals or without. So, I'm going to make a sort of table. Oh, S without decimals, the 2-bit. S with decimals, 32-bit. Without decimals, the 6-bit. With decimals. Okay, but now you think I can always use float because that's the best. It has the most features. Well, no. If you have a 62-bit number, it requires more computer power to calculate on things like that, and that's the same for decimals. And if you don't understand something of my code, say it. Okay, we are starting with integers because they are the easiest. How do we declare integer? Well, we can do integer and then number is 5 or 6, but this is wrong. Okay, because if you want to calculate with it, it's not really calculating, because integer is the object version of int. Sometimes you need to use the object because it requires an object, but it's better to calculate with ints. It's the same, but this one is not an object. Number 0. Now you have one thing you need to watch from. about, because numbers start with zero. Always, they start always zero in programming languages. So watch out with that, because programming languages always start with the number zero. Okay, we want to calculate. We just made a sort of object if the number null, if with the variable number null, or that has null inside. If we print this system out dot print number zero and we run it, okay, but I'm going to make a method. I'm not done with the numbers, but I'm going to make it easier. But because who wants to type system.out.print line every time? So we are going to make a method. Okay, how do you make method? You go out of that method and you type wow. I need to kick people. That's the same person again. You know. And I don't like that. They are saying words what I don't like. But yeah, I'm talking English and you guys can't read it after this. So we're going to make him an method. So just type what I do, public, same as there, static, same as there, void, same as there, on the p, because I don't want to type print, I just want to type one letter, that's everything. So then we want a string. Oh no, wait, it's better to do an object, because string is an object, and the number is an object. But if we want a string, and these are the requirements for the method, if you want to do only a string, we can only type only get a string. But if you want to type a number, well, that's not possible, because we need to make it a string then first. But object is always possible. So system out print line object. Done. How do we call the print now? With p and then the object. This runs this. Now it's hard, but yeah. But now you want to add something to the number. So number is number plus 5. Why not? But now we are going to print it again. And stop it. Always end with a dot comma. And run. Okay, waiting for the run. And you have 5. Okay. But instead of doing that strange, I'm going to make a new number. Okay, but who wants to type a number 0 2 times? Why? Okay, number 1 plus is, or then 5. It's exactly the same, but we don't have to type that. Okay. Okay, but now we can use variables with variables. Okay, and we got twice the 5. Okay. Number 3 is not just a number, but it's number 1, number 0 plus number 1. Oh, this needs to be a 2. So this should return. Hello TLTV, welcome to this live stream. I'm going to make a a programming game, and I'm going to help you guys with it as a tutorial. And now it returns 10. So yeah, we made 0 and 1 together. Okay, but now I'm going to make some examples. Instead of making a variable like we did here, we're going to make it in here. So what about 5? And okay, these are the things we have. 5 adding. Okay, now 5 minus 5 times 5. We have almost everything, but watch out. This is a star, this is a slash. Need to watch out with that. Okay, now we want to do power of 5. But a root, a square root. How do we do that? Math dot. Oh wait. Okay, what's the game you're coding? Well, I'm coding not a game. I'm just explaining the basics of Java, and then I'm going to make a little game. So let's run this code. Okay, we start from here. 10. 5 plus 10. Of 5 plus 5 is 10. 5 minus 5. 0. Yes. But wait. Zero. Wait, I did something wrong. Wow. That needs to be math dot mod. Wait. Power, yes. 5 by 5. And we have some. Wow. Don't make it easier for us. No. Okay. So now it should work. Okay. But yeah, these are the basics from the string on the numbers and some methods. I'm going to leave it like well, you can watch on it now. That on that. Okay, and now I can close this. Now we are going to code a little easy program. First, I'm going to make this a new file. Comments. And I'm going to paste this in. What about the percentage? Okay. So, okay. Okay, I need to do a percentage. Okay, and now I'm going to run it, and I will. Maybe I'm going to do a little next, so we can stop. Okay, load. Okay, need to look here. The 10? Yes. 0? Yes. 35? Okay, here. Why do you want to add a dot 0? Well, this is a double and it has decimals, so it adds a dot 0. On the okay, I don't get that, but okay. Let's start with the game. So we want to start with a simple easy game for the console. So when we type something in here, when we type something in here, called let's say start. Nah, I'm going to make rock, paper, scissors. Okay, let's make rock, paper, scissors. So when we run the console, we are going to make we want the user to give an x or o. So how do we get the how do you want to get the input? We do it with scanner. Scanner is new scanner. But it returns red. You can't resolve the constructor of scanner. So you can type this and do it and wait for it so you know what to do. It's very easy to fix. Oh, sorry. It's like the same as system. So you type system.in. And then we get the next line. Okay. This is the input. But we want to get to send a message. Can we put a message in here? No. We are going to send a message as a string. Do you want a O? Want to be O or X? Okay, so when we run this code, and it's saying here process finished with exit code 0. Now we get the question. I want to be, and it stopped because we are not done yet. So now we are going to start with the if statement. The if statement is to check for things. So input dot equals, and then the same brackets as the method. Okay, we want to check for x. Now we are going to make okay, now I will type the string char. That stands for character, and it can only hold one character. So player is, instead of doing this, we need to do this. Watch out for that. But now we are going to give nothing because it okay, but now, if you're not an X, we want to be an O. So, just do an else statement, and do the same with 10, but then an O. But but that's and then oh. Let's send the player. Because I made something wrong. Because the else statement is not useful always useful. So yeah, let's do oh. Okay. He knows I'm an O. Yes. Okay. Now I want to be an X. I'm an X. Yes. But what happens if I type something different, like an A? I'm an O. That's the else statement. It returns always. It always does this when this is false. Yeah. So you're going to make this different if this is an else if statement. Input equals O. Else player is O. Input plus is not valid. Stopping program done with that. Okay, but it's giving a variable player might not have been initialized. Because it has nothing now, but we want to give it something, so we add a null. But that's not possible for char. So we do something like a space. Now run the code. Okay, I want to be an O. Oh, okay. I want to be an X. Yes. Now an A. A is not valid. Stopping program. And he stopped. Well, you can see the space here. So, yeah, that's a little problem. So we are going to fix that. We are going to do a boolean. A boolean is always true or false. So boolean go further is false. Is true. Yes. Now if go further is We can't do equals here because it's not an object, like you can see here. Or we need to do it like this. Now it's an object, but we don't want an object. Instead of doing this, because we want everything shorter, you can remove this. It's just go further as true. It's the same. So now we got this. But it's always true. So we need to say no. We don't want to go further. Run the code. And oh, nope. Not doing it. X, nope, not doing it. But now an A, and we then got an space. So that's everything for now. I think we can remove it now because IntelliJ is smart. Nope, it's not smart enough. Oh, but Yeah, that's everything for now. You can experiment with this on the comments. You can go back for the comments. And I hope you will have a nice day. Have fun with coding. I will see you guys next time.